Did they scare you? Hi. They're just gloves.
Don't scare me.
Put one on Ryan's hand. Should we put one on Ryan's hand? Here, Ryan, put it on your left hand. Other hand. Left.
Yeah.
Spread your fingers out. There. You want to put it on, Mariah?
No.
No? You don't like gloves?
No.
No?
I can say no.
She knows how to say no very well, don't you? Or she knows how to say, my bear. My bear.
My.
Oh, your bear?
Oh. My chair.
My chair. If you sit in there, she probably can even say, my chair. My chair, huh? You like that chair? Is that your chair?
I don't care what.
Do you remember when Uncle Matt or Dad, I don't remember who it was, got you a musical instrument like that for Christmas one year? Did you remember when he got you my first tape recorder?
Yeah.
I don't know if this is hot enough. But
thank you.
Not burning hot, but...
I have a pair of pajamas.
Oh, really?
Well, I never wear them because my waist is too big. And they're tight. But you said you needed some more pajamas.
I need pajamas. But I'm frozen solid all the time. Okay. I never wear them because the gowns I have are either short sleeve or short.
Yeah.
Or there's straps.
Those are great in the sun. Yeah. I'll bring these over and then if you want them. I really have only worn them maybe once. In my drawer for several years, so I'll bring them in if you want them. You can.
Okay. Yeah, definitely pajamas is on the Christmas list for them. I mean, anybody.
You filming me? You filming me while I film you?
Really? You know what you guys need?
I don't like that.
No. You need a down comforter.
A down
comforter so it can warm.
See, he gets hot.
Yeah.
See, he can't stand the heat. I'm freezing all the time, and he's fine. So, it's a matter of me wearing warmer clothes to bed. That's what it is.
It's down comforter.
He can't even stand the comforter with him. So
really?
Yeah. And I have the heat on 75 if you're not married. Because you'll have to do it again if you don't get everything you need to get. And it's sometimes kind of painful. And so it's very frustrating at times. So, but he's really sticks real close by. If
Ryan?
I don't talk to him, usually he calls me.
Is that Ryan? You like
yeah,
Ryan?
Oh
boy, she's getting climby.
You know, a lot of things can happen. Oh, I can't even put cologne on my body anymore. I can put on my clothes and leave the room. Just bring my clothes and leave the room. Because I have a horrible reaction to it now. Because see, there's not the whole system after 4 months. So
I
react terribly to a lot of things.
Ah, there we go.
I have to be very careful.
There we go.
All it'll do is make me really
chicken
nasty. Make me very unhappy.
What about
rinsing hairspray? Is that Ryan?
I use spritzer. And there's not that much aerosol. It's just a quick spritz and then I get the hair out of
there. Disney Pictures, Rescuers
because
Down Under, starring Bernard and Bianca.
Ah.
Have you seen the movie? Is it out? It's not out yet.
Touch of the ribs.
Look,
you can get real nasty. You can stay that way all day.
Huh? Well, that's where the little pictures are, huh?
Your system. If you're not very careful, you're going to send you right down the river. These are things that you watch. You know, I mean,
what you got?
The symptom of a true alcoholic. You don't watch this for the rest of your life.
What?
It's not that hard. Think about it. Just make sure that some of the things you use,
little,
like my deodorant's fine. You know, I
snowman.
Make sure there's no alcohol in certain
snowman.
There's a lot of things out. People don't even realize
oh,
that.
I know.
But I don't drink non-alcoholic beer or wine anymore.
Snow's cold.
I feel
like
a reaction from it. Even though it's 1.5%. See, there's not been any alcohol in my system for a long time. So now, if I get anything with anything in it, I'll get real irritable.
Back on?
Yeah.
I have to blow it up?
Crabby. And real. It'll make me real angry.
That's enough for her.
You know, because it's just that way.
Now I
put
that
thing on. Haven't been around for a long time, because at first it's just a slow draw, but it's an allergy in the body. It's a physical allergy for most people.
No. I should be playing.
But then you find out that that's what alcohol is really a symptom.
What happens if you do something and you find out?
You can usually
Right.
Start to get your
right. Yeah.
And you won't feel good.
What are you doing for Christmas?
You just will not feel good. You know,
and
sometimes
it
turns irritation.
Oh, you saw Santa Claus?
You can cook it all out.
Oh, he came in your car?
And he gave us a candy book.
Really cook the one.
Hey, that's neat.
And you can still eat.
And a candy cane?
It doesn't upset you.
He came to your car?
Probably red wine vinegar.
Where was that?
This was on the street by my house.
It actually happened. Santa Claus got in the car with him.
Really?
But then Ryan told me on the way over here that actually what they did was Santa Claus, they went to the North Pole with Santa Claus and checked out his reindeer. And I said, well, I'm not sure about that part of it. I know he got in the car with you because the lady next door told me she had taken him down to the basket place or something with Santa Claus. Was there.
Got in the car. Got right in the car.
He had to tell me that they went to the North Pole and saw his reindeer.
Well, yeah, what's Santa doing?
They were real cute.
Oh boy.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm in the part now.
Work, I have to work.
You go through, I don't know how much you know that, but you have the people, the principals, and the institutions. And what you do is you make lists of all the things. And one girl said it perfectly the other night. She says, I just couldn't wait to write down everybody and everything that had messed me up and done something to me. And then you turn it around and you find out it's not the people, it's not the institutions, it's not the principals, it's you. You perceive and see you're completely out of whack.
Well, that's something I guess that.
So that's the hard part.
You say is that.
Oh yeah, see that? See that little binder over there? People, institutions. There's a lot of writing. All that will be stuffed into one of our pages.
Oh, this is what, honey?
It's amazing.
Did you blow this up for her?
Yeah.
Did you blow that up for her? Where did this come from, sweetheart?
John gave it to me.
Oh, how nice.
And you're giving it to her? You
will say
thank you.
Oh, that's awfully nice. Maybe
Ronald McDonald.
Thank you, Ryan. Ryan gave that balloon to you.
So you want to tie it around there? That's awfully nice, honey.
Oh, sweet. Yeah. Say thank you, Mariah. Tell Ryan thank you. He's going to give you a balloon.
Right, thank you. Yeah, she said Ryan thank
She's
you.
Really talking.
She is.
There you go.
She talks very
well. There's your balloon, Ronald McDonald's honey. On the front of that.
Yeah, Ronald McDonald.
See?
Mini piano, pencil box. Piano and pencil box.
Right. In the music inside, there's the written music. It'll tell you what to play certain songs, which buttons to push. So now she has a keyboard like yours, kind of. Just a smaller version, less complicated.
Balloon. Yes, it's a yellow balloon, and Ryan gave you that yellow balloon.
Uh huh.
You know how to toss the balloon up in the air and let it come down and hit it again?
That's right. That's right.
Hey.
Oh, boy, look at that.
Yay, volleyball girl.
There you go, babe.
We've been at the playground hanging upside down on the bars and stuff. I'm not as agile as I used to be.
Yeah?
Oh, I know. I'm not either. Or at least to swing on those monkey bars all the time.
Yeah.
Eric, will you tell me when you're ready to go, okay?
We should probably go.
Because I'm not keeping track of the time.
It's 5:51.
Oh, okay.
How long does it take to get there?
I don't know how long it takes in the car.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's
Whoa!
So what are you guys doing later tonight? You going out to dinner?
Well, we have to go back and see Bob and
talk to him.
Find out what Bob wants to do and stuff. Yeah.
Okay.
The last time we went to your restaurant, you didn't get a chance to say hi. He'd go, Eric, and you'd be running to the.
If you came in when I was getting off my shift, that would be great. But right at dinner time is not a good time. I'm usually pretty busy. But if you came in around 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock.
Okay. Sometime we'll plan it. We'll go in later.
Okay.
Yeah. That's.
We'll all go together.
That's easy. Then I can usually stand.
He was talking about milkshakes, and I said, I don't think you make milkshakes at that restaurant.
Yeah, we can.
Oh, can you?
I never have yet.
But you can.
But it's, you can make them.
So another time we'll go in and
visit.
Get that balloon going.
Work, and then he can sit down.
Get that balloon going.
Yeah. Be more fun then, huh? Yeah.
Yeah, Chris, my stepsister, came in with her boyfriend.
Oh, really?
Her fiance, I guess.
Did she know you worked there?
Yeah, but she didn't know I was working there that night.
You may not
get. Okay. to get going.
Thanks for the coffee. Sorry to run like this so fast, yeah. Little one.
Bye-bye.
Yes.
Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Ryan. That's what she's saying, honey. She's saying, bye-bye, Rye.
Sure, her name's rhymes with her. Her name rhymes with yours.
That's right.
Kind of.
Mariah and Ryan.
Right.